Hello everyone, my name is Leo and today we'll play a little at the party poker. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. And I think that you'll play today for 4 or 5 hours, I think. And we'll try to earn some money today. Type please, is everything okay with the sound? Can you hear the music? And can you hear me? We have a 3 minutes delay, so I would answer your questions in 3 minutes. Checking our suited, we should protect here. And I would not fold against the c-bet on this flop. And depending on his size, he bets rather weak size, so I think we could go and check raise here for like 7.4 big blinds. Well, card for me to continue my regression. And get fold again. I think good start for me. I had a plan to continue bluffing on my cards, like a diamond card or something connected with my hand. Get called by small blinds. Get a gut shot. I don't want to bluff against two opponents. I would play check behind here. I don't want to see bet in such flop. I would go check behind. I don't want to pay with a gut shot. I will just fold here. I hope for the better flop. ace 9 off suited. I don't want to 3-bet against the early position. So I will just fold here. 8-7 suited. With the weak player here, I would just call. Just to make him call. We cannot do anything here just because of him behind. That's why we had to fold. If we play heads up here, I would go and check raise. But okay, it's not a problem. Queen to suited. I don't want to call with this hand just because of my position. If I'd be on the button or a big blind, I would call this. I would more possible call. Here we should protect just because of his size. And bad flop for us. Fold bet, okay, it's yours. Maybe later, if everything would be okay, we would add some tournaments from PokerStars. We'll try from Party, and then maybe we'll add something. Here I cannot open with my weak hand just because of my stack size. Here we should isolate against his limping. And get called. I would continue here. And I need to pick big size just because I want him to fold his overcards, and I would bet only once. That's why I pick the bigger size and flop. Not a good card for me to continue my aggression, so I need to check here and to give up. It's held a manager that you are using. No, it is hand to note, but I have them both. It's because I need to use my holding manager for working with my statistics, and for playing I use hand to note. Here we should bet, and here we should bet, but need to bet huge size to go all in on turn. Versus flush draw. Hold, okay. But you know, this heads up display for hand to node, it is similar to my heads up display for holding manager. So if you're using my heads-up display, they are really very close, very similar. Here I would 3-bet with my hand, just I want to stay in heads up. We can't, I wouldn't open it from the hijack. That's why, that's why I decided to fold. Also, as a software, I use the body caption to get all these binds, pot odds, and this info about the position, price, and ITM zone. It helps me to play a lot of tables simultaneously. Thank you, Yaojin Tonic 85. Thank you for the subscription. If maybe you have any questions, you can ask. We have a low stack here so that we cannot open with King 8 suited. But also, if it have more chips, we'll not open this hand, so it doesn't matter. Here we flop the top pair with a weak kicker, and my opponent decided to donkey bet. We can call here with the second pair. I think we should raise here, just because if he has a flush draw, he maybe will not pay on the river, not bluff against him, against me. So I would raise. Yeah, we got a KO. We have like 3 starting stacks. Good beginning for us. Here is 8-4 seated. I would call. And I would use stop and go. But not on this board. Is really bad for me, and I'll just give up here. I needed a bird without ace, without jack. At least with my flush draw. Here we have a weak hand, but versus min raise, we should protect. Bet versus miss c-bet. Very fast call. I don't think we are better here, and I'll just fold. If the 3-bet, let's say, from the button, should you almost all the time make c-bet or when you should check? It is a good question, and no, I shouldn't c-bet almost every time. I just need to pick the right boards for my preflop range, so I wouldn't c-bet on a7-9 with a flush draw just because my opponents wouldn't believe me. But if, for example, I would hit the board with ace, king, queen, then I would continue. Here I want to make a check raise with my hand. I got a cold 4-bet. Need to check who is he using the shark scope. Probably he is a weak player. I would call here because I'm in position. I won't let him bluffing games against me. Huge sizes. Ah, mistake. Should call here. I should raise here. Wow. Ace queen offsuited. I don't like his bluff. I think that now maybe he is tilting. That's why I would call against his all-in if he decide to go. And about the 3-bet pots and c-betting, you just need to know, can your opponent hit the board that you're seeing? And if he is not, you can continue your bluffing. But if you're playing micro, then you can c-bet almost in every board. The more expensive limits you are playing, then the more complicated strategy your strategy should be. Yeah. He is in tilt. So hope that we would pick his bounty. Well played. King gate off, we cannot shove. Thank you, Papa Tour, for subscribe. Welcome on our channel. Here with 3-bets, if he raises. Out of position, I use bigger sizes. Just because I want him to fold. Click 4-bets. Just because of the KO, I would call here, looking for two pairs or something like that. Here I would give up. Here we are. Yep. And on this table, I just check folded flop. It was a plan. I wouldn't 3-bet here just because I make already two raises against him. So I want to keep calm here. Here I want to call with my hand and I would go all in on almost every flop. Now I can't. Thanks for subscription, TrugVFP. Welcome on channel. Here I can't call, so just fold. Oh, I almost forgot, today you'll have, as you've seen on the first screen, giveaway. We'll make a little quiz to get a free lesson with me. It could be a hand review, a theoretical lesson, as you wish. So all you need is to answer my question. I'll ask this question maybe in 1 or 2 hours, so stay tuned. And if you are interested, you can win a free lesson. All you need is just to have your database, your hand history, so that we could work with it. Oh, it was a mistake. I should go all in here with my king high. Just misclicked. I would bluff here on this board. I just want him to fold all his weak pairs. And I will not bet 2 times, so I again pick great size. Here just fold. Jack 9. And go all in after raise it. What else can we play today? Gladiator, but running time is 1.5 hour, so we are late. Deep freeze for $11. Okay. And added something from Poker Stars a little bit later. Bad luck for us, but it's not a problem. Here we are, see that. Present. I think that we should add something from different poker rooms, because we don't have a lot of tournaments to play. What team are you using for your tables? It is the same layout. It is called same layout. Just type it in Google. It has a free version and a purchasing version, and you can pick wherever you want. Again, same layout. I would bet 2 times here. But because it's not easy for him to call, he get a top pair, so that's why he didn't fold against my second barrel. By the way, the same layout looks pretty similar to Poker Stars. Should check it, I think, here how it looks in Poker Stars. I think that we should bet here, just because we have hands to continue on turn. I don't think that we should bet here a second time, but we can check call versus all his bluffs. And I think that we can bluff here to make his 9x fold. Ace is a good hand for us, a good card. But he has a top pair. Okay. Leo, Elysian Poker, it's not a problem. It's okay. You can call me Leo or Leon. Just I have a 3 minutes delay, so that's why I answer your question not from the beginning. Okay, here we should isolate, here open raise, call, should c-bet, here we should check call. Here we can continue because we have cards to continue, like Jack 7, 10, 9. Got 3 bets. Can't continue here just because we don't have flashes. That's why we need to give up. Here we'd continue. I don't need to continue here just because I wouldn't let him, I wouldn't make him to fold his ace or jack, and all his other hands are beaten by me, so I would check behind. Now we have 6-8 active tables. So it would be a little bit more interesting. Need to see bet here in my hand versus big blind range. Here I would check call. Not a good card for me on the river. Whoa, we win this pot. I wonder did he 9-8. Ah, he got a showdown. That's why he decided to check on the river. Interesting decision. I think that his 9 is not okay for checking here. And he should bluff on the river. To make me fold low aces like I has. Like I have, sorry. I would open here my king nine suited just because we are playing short table without player here, so my position is not UTG. I need to change my playlist. It sounds like an anthem. Here would make it lazy bets. Because we have fair flop. And if I had an ace, I would probably check and flop and see bet on turn. That's why I decide to play the similar line with King 9. Here 1-3 bets. Would see bet flop and check call on turn. I don't expect him to have a lot of bluffs in his betting river range. That's why I want to bet here and check all turn. It's okay. Interesting spot here. Wow, quads. Ace 10. So bad, and like cooler maybe. Can we fold here? Ace 10 on the river? I don't think so. Value betting here with our queen. We are value betting against the ace high. Here I'll check behind and I want to bluff catch on the river. Thank you, Benny. Decided to fold. Think that he has something like 4, and maybe my bet size make him default. I don't think that he thought about calling with ace high here. Anyway, let's see you guys. Thank you for coming. Interesting spot. The sevens. I decided to call here with pocket sevens. Strange bet on the river. On turn, sorry. And he gets king high. Here I want to go all in just because of the KO. Fold is okay. I want a 3-bet with my hand. I think it is okay because of my position. Here I would be pot controlling just because of my weak hand. Coin flip, king on flop. Yep. Instead, you just squish push here. And here we go. So, 5 minutes break. 4k days is in Gladiator. Looks really careful from me. But he's a hero. Yeah, only 12% equity versus my hand. I don't want to protect this hand, I will just fold. He don't want a 3-bet just because his bet size is really low, and it was successful. Hero just call, just want him to go all in, or him. And I would call both of them. Yep. But he has 40 bigs. No. I don't want to call here. I think that is a good fold. Hello, welcome to my stream. I don't know anything about this opponent, so I wouldn't steal here with my hand. Interesting spot here because we have very low 3-bet, but I think we should call here. Just because if it hit the nuts, it would be very good for us. Yeah, top set. I hope that he has aces or kings, because his 3-bet was very low. And we have $15 KO for him. $15 bounty. Yep, pocket kings. Easy reading. And $15 KO. If he 3 bet bigger size, I would just fold with my pocket sevens, just because he wants to make a trap. I called. I don't think that we can call here in both situations. Ace king versus kings. Low stack here. I would go all in if everybody would fold. I hope they will fold. Should fold here. Yeah, we have a bounty winner. Also, I want to say that this red letters, it is the hand history, so that I could play a lot of hands and a lot of tables, and it helps me to multi-tabling. Here we're going all in just because of their bounties. Whoa, pocket queens, bad luck for me. But it's not a problem, I still had a huge stack. So continue playing. Also, I use hotkeys and I don't use my left hand. I just do everything only by clicking on a mouse. I have low kicker, so I cannot check raise here, I would just check call. Bad card for me on river. 4B7-7, yep. Lucky flop. I have interesting hands. I'll show you it just in a minute. Just need to play. Personal fun, yep. I'm very fun for last like 10, 15 years, you know? And in this year, Arsenal came to my country and I was on this match, so that's where I find this scarf. Interesting hand. Here we can just fold. Look, please. Oh, he's had to raise with 10-8. Let me increase the size. Yeah, having 10-8 seated. It click 3-bet. It called. And we have an overbet here. And I don't think that he could play with this size with hands like ace queen, king queen, queen jack, because it is a really dry board. So I decided to call here. And he got pocket fives. So, yep. I like this soccer team for almost 15 years. It is difficult to cheer for them, but still I like this team. Going all in just because of his stack. Jump into the car on a Friday night. I want to drive with you. Looking for a bar in the nearest town. I've never seen a sky so blue. We don't ever play it in the night is young. It doesn't matter what we do. Ain't nobody like. Ain't nobody like. You look so beautiful. I think that we can raise here with our hands. Just because we have a really massive stack. Bad luck for me. I could go 1,000 miles as long as I'm with you. Yeah, you're taking me high. Interesting pot here. I would call here just because of the size. And if he had something strong and I'll hit my set, I think that he would pay. He would pay a lot. That's why I called here. We didn't get a set. But he has in his range ace, king, ace, queen, so I would call. But versus such huge bets, I would just fold. I would have stronger hands here to call. I'm a Liverpool fan, and Barcelona too. Now I live in Spain, here in Barcelona. Wow! It's cool. Do you remember the final stage of the Champions League? Match between the Arsenal and Barcelona. Yeah, do you remember? Red card. I will not forget it. But hope that this year Arsenal will win the Europa League. And also, Liverpool had great chances in this season in Premier League. I don't think that we can bluff here just because his checking range on this board includes a lot of queen x, jacks, tens, nine. I would just give up here. Just because of very coordinated board. We have 20 minutes of play registration here in Bounty Builder. Can't do anything here with our hand, just have to fold. Big blinds, but so many players behind. It's called by the opponents. I don't want to bluff here. I don't want to continue my aggression here. But I would pay to mix. Wow. Wow. Yeah, you remember. Crazy poker here. Limp call. Just shove for 25 bigs. Doesn't have a good team now. Yeah, I agree. Naimiri, he works hard, and I hope that with the help of the Europe League we'll come into the Champions League next season. All we need is just to win this tournament. He would. Then we need to isolate here. He'll play in Augusta in live tournament in Barcelona. You know, I don't place it lights to Barcelona now, because I'm living in a country that is far from Spain. Okay, limp call. Ah, my fault. I didn't see bet flop. My mistake. So no, I will not play these tournaments. Yep. Also, could squeeze here. Maybe it's not the best decision to just to call here. Another interesting spot. I called against the short stack and I decide to lead on turn just because of his stack size. He cannot do anything if he doesn't have at least flush draw, so I think that the success rate of this lead would be really, really high. That's why I decided to bet here and he just folded. Hit the top set. I think that we can make him go all in using two bets, so I can check on flop. If I'd raise now, I'd make him fold with all his hand. Bad card for me, because it is scary. It's careful for him. Just try to get at least something from him and get called by 9, yep. And again. I say to call versus recreational player on preflop. And bet twice against his check because his checking range is really weak. And it's a good card for me to continue my bluff just because it is totally in my calling range. That's why I bet more two more times and get fold. By the way, we have a good stack in Big Turbo on PartyPoker. So maybe we'll win something in this tournament. Hit the top pair. Interesting. Here I have to go all in, just because I have a really huge pot, have a flush draw, and hope will improve until flush. Good luck to us. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Yeah. Yeah. Really cool stack now. Lucky turn for us. And ace is here. Good evening today. Get called. I need to bet something like 5 big blinds now, and all in on turn. Okay. Cooler. Get squeezed, so we don't have enough stack to call here just because of him behind, that's why we have to fold here. Our hand is strong, but not for this situation. I cannot play it out of position really well. is such low effective stack size. I think we can open here just because of his bounty. He doesn't want to present his bounty, okay? It's not a problem. And again, this board is totally ours, that's why I decided to bet and turn, even I don't have anything, just say it's high. Such epic soundtrack. Like Lord of the Rings or the Game of Thrones or something. Straight versus straight here. I think we can continue here. It's difficult for him to call. Bad cards for us. But I would check all turn. And also I'll give up on the river. I don't want to call here just because if I call turn, I have to call the river, and it's a really expensive spot for me. I don't really expect him to continue bluffing in blank card. Maybe with really low frequency. So I decide to fold here with my second pair. Okay. I don't think that I could make him fold with his top pair by edge crazy on flop and going all in on turn. But from his point, I think this mistake to c-bet in such board with his hand just because I have a lot of nuts here and he hasn't. He just have only top pair. So I don't like his decision here. Hold. Yep. By the way, we have the second stack in this tournament. Big turbo. So maybe we'll see final table here today. There is $600 for the first place. Not bad, I think. I think that we just have to give up. I need to protect my hand here, that's why I decided to bet. I don't expect him of checking behind here with the pair or something like that, that's why I should bet to protect my hand from six outs. Double up for the short stack. New table again. We have one short stack, two. Okay, not the worst table. I called preflop with my hand and just bet versus me c-bet and it's over. Okay, it's almost the bubble time here because we have 2050 ITM places. So we should be careful. But we can fall here as our hand. I think we can make a block bet here. Make him fold his 6. And protect ourselves from bluffing. Trips on board, but low kicker. How many hours you play poker in one day? It depends. And like from 4 to 8, 10 hours, but I don't play every day just because I work in the Academy of Poker. That's why I have some free days. So I'm playing poker. I play poker for 3 or 4 days a week, including one day from the weekend, Saturday or Sunday. I didn't want to bet here just because we had really strong hands. And with it, we could go on the showdown. And even if he decided to bluff, I would call just because of the bounty. With King 10, I cannot continue my aggression just because it's not my card. I didn't get any improvements. I think we should open here just because of here short stack, and I want their bounty, and I would call if they got in. Hi there, Oleg. Cannot do anything here, just have to fold. Well played by my opponent. Not protect our hand against such huge bet. I wanted to fight for this bounty, but this call, I don't think that I should go all in here just because he would call against me because he has more chips in his stack. Four bigs here. I want to call. Sorry, I want to go all in. But I don't think that it would be a good decision. But I want it. Almost 20 places left to the ITM zone here. We have a huge pot here. Get it upset. And I think that we should be a chip leader here in this tournament. Let me check it. No, no, we had a second stack again. So let's fight. Let's fight for the KO. Coin flip. No. No chances here. At least we tried. Such a huge bet. I tried to bluff and flop because I had a lot of backdoors, but six of spades. Is a little trash for me. You make a good job in Academy Poker, I'm Benjamin. I try to learn something with your help. You're welcome. Just keep in mind that you have three individual lessons. So don't forget to use them. Maybe I'll help you much more than just giving you a theory on our group lessons. We have 8 players left until the bubble here. And, you know, I think that I should go all in here with my hand, just because it's a really good situation, and he will not call me without a good hand because it's very expensive for him, because he has only 25 big blinds. And I go all in for 15. It is really difficult to call on the big bubble. By the way, only 4 players left until the ITM zone. Yeah, achievement. We are a chip leader here. 10 for hand in the gladiator. But the minimum price is only $11, just like a buy-in. So we need to... Great prizes here. 1.3 thousand, just regular prize pool, also plus bounty. So great tournament. We should try to win it. So again, a 5 minute break. See you soon. We are here. And we are getting into money in this $11 buy-in tournament. Also, we've made 1 KO, I think. So our next task here is to reach the final table. But not with the help of the Jack 4 offsuit. Whoa. What an action. They just were waiting for the bubble time. And now they want to... Wow, what a cooler. And I will beat all of them. But I can't. I couldn't, sorry. Bad flop for me. It's difficult. But anyway, I have a good stack. I think that it's our time. Need to double up here because there are almost 150 places till the bubble. And I think that he should call against me with all his raising range, and with pocket sevens I'm ready for it. But after a 3-bet, I can't do anything, just have to fold. We'll see, did he save me or not. Oh, 4-bet, I think. I should say thank you for Ukrainian guy. He saved my life. I'm pretty sure. And good luck for us. We want to double up here. No. No chances. Thank you, Ladislav. Good stack here for 2.1 million chips. And here I would call against his min raise. Oh, nice nickname. Eyes on the prize. I like it really. Get the top pair, would check call flop. Fast bet from him. So, good luck, guys. I'll go. Eight on the river, and we are alive. It's all about your good aura. We are getting up like a true gladiator, and I hope that we'll reach the final. So hand for hand here, and I expect that we'll get into money with our stack. I don't want to get into this spot with our hand, it is really weak, especially in multipots. Especially on small blinds, so we'll be out of position. So it was an easy fold. I will protect here my big blind. Should continue here. Yeah. It was difficult for him to call my button turn just because of the bubble time. Also, on this table, there are only 10 players left until the ITM. But I have a short stack. I hope they'll manage to reach the money here. We still have a bubble time, that's why I would put pressure on my opponents. I would go all in here if you decide to race. Against him, we'll just shove. I would do it with any two hands. King Jack off. I can't call. I just can go and 4-bet here, but I don't know anything about him. So I think we should give up. If I had a little bit more info about him, maybe I would make a 4-bet, but. Ace Jack, Ace Queen. And steal hand for hand. What are you waiting for? I just would show off against him. If I were him, I would fold here with ace queen even. So that's why I push here. And even if he has a strong hand, then okay. I have a strong hand too. Steal hand over hand. We have two players here. I don't think they can bluff here. Here I decided to raise for 3 big blinds to put more pressure on my opponent on the big blind. I think here we can just fold with our hands because he was a bet in the call. He cannot call with trash. And he wouldn't bluff in my board against two opponents, so I think that it was a good fold. Okay, we're in the money here. How many all-ins? Well, quads from flop or the short stack. Also, item here. So now we need to double up, but not with this hand. I don't think that we should call here with our hands. Good situation for wrestling. And good hand. New table. We cannot call here just because it will provoke the short stack for going all in, and we cannot call against him because of this guy. I don't want to open pocket sixes from the early position. Rather weak hand. If I had pocket eights, I would open, of course. Probably it would be better to go all in here with my hand, just because a lot of dead money here, 5, 6, 6.5, 7.5, almost half of my stack. So yeah, well played. And I have to fold. My mistake, I should push here first. I hope you won with this tournament, it will be great. Thank you. I'll do my best. I'll call here. Oh. He even didn't try to bluff. Okay. Cannot call here in multi-way. A lot of short stacks here. That's why we cannot play post club. It's a problem. Because bubble time is over and now I cannot put pressure on them. I thought that open raising here would be really careful, so I decided just to push with my pocket jacks. I'll not call his river bet. I have a plan to give up. And I think that he should check here with his other pairs if he has something like that. Yeah. Interesting spot here. I think that I should mark it. I called turn here because of his bet sizing. I think that 9 is my card. And if I were him, I wouldn't bet such big amount of chips just because I could easily check shove here. And what should he do with his other pair? So maybe it is one of the reasons because why I decided to call and turn. Interesting, yeah? He bets more, and that's why I want to call more. I will protect here and here. I don't think that I should lead on the river here. Yeah. Good luck. Could have a quartz here. I have finished my Poker Stars tournament with a minimum payout. can protect our hand here. It is too weak. There are three tables left here. Cannot open his hand because of the short stack on the big blind. I think it was a mistake. I should call here with King 7 just because of his bounty. Look, I'll not protect against three big blinds with my offsuited hand. Well, two short stacks here. At least sideboard. I think that they understood something. And I need to come down and stop pressing the table. Emotion, of course I have. Just I try to be really concentrated while playing. And if I don't have any questions in chat, then I can be fully in the game. If you're asking about, do I have any worries about this tournament? No. Just rather a small tournament. And if I win it, it would be cool. If I'm not, okay, it's not a problem because it has much more tournaments. He decided just to go all in against me and I cannot call. All in again, should be great. So, I don't have huge emotions now. But I will, if I want it, if I win it. Ah, mistake. I should 3-bet here with my hand. He checked the flop. Maybe he has a low pair. No. Give up. Just give up. Why did he check and flop with his hand? Queen 7, 3. I would call here. It's called stop and go. I just don't go in pre-flop and push on flop. Double up for the short stack. I want to play here with my hands. Cannot bluff in such turn. A trap from him. Or maybe he just plays aggressively against low stack size. Low bet size. Who knows? I don't like the T-bet in such board. Just totally his. Same here. Bad river for me. No. Whoa. Interesting. I just want to provoke him to go all in. Hold. Come on. Three hands in a row. And only eight in place. Here I should squeeze. No chances. So I think that we can stop our streaming session. Thank you for coming. And see you tomorrow. Our training lesson will make a hand review.